been praying a lot more lately, trying harder to get away from this evil group. And looking back now, as I'm starting to see how I was in a dungeon in my own home through my weapons and stalkers, I see how they drained my soul, they took my talent, they destroyed my body. And so now I'm telling myself that my God is stronger than their devil, and I have all these angels around me, and I'm trusting more the universe. And then I realized when I was younger, and I thought everyone had talent, like I was promoting Frankie Valli, I was writing songs, I was helping everyone else live their dreams. I wrote songs, and one of my wrote the first one about Heart Souvenir. Well, then the first one, and which was the first one? Was it Heart Souvenir? Settle Down, Little Girl was the first song. Then Bloodsworth, then Heart Souvenir, then Angelica. But Heart Souvenir was an early song I wrote, and then it was put into part of a song by a gothic band in UK, like in the 90s. But my first script I ever did, it was turned into a horror story, and there was a sequel made off of it. But anything it seems I've written with passion was always used. So I never had any confidence. Even when I went to see my own work at the theater, and it had even the characters' names I put in my script that were mountain kinfolk from the distant past, I still didn't want to believe it was my work. I was so down on myself. I had no confidence. And these people that latched onto me, they took advantage of my naivety, and they beat me down more. So here I am thinking everyone in the world has talent, but I don't have any. But I love people, and I want to help them, their dreams come true. And I'm helping these people's dreams come true. Famous people. But I don't feel that good. And I mean, I remember when I first met some directors in California when I was working out there. And one of them wanted me to go dancing at Dimples and hang out with them. And he was, Jerry Weiss was his name. He did a show called Small Wonder. And after I got married to my husband, we went to his house and everything, and he took me to Universal Studios, and we had Chinese, and he said, you know, you can get into the entertainment industry, but it's, there's a lot of times there's a casting couch, but there's ways around it. And I told him that I was a Christian at the time, but I did not want to get into television or that kind of work, but he liked me from, he said, because I was different. That's what he liked. Because the first night he met me, I'd had my bus ticket home stolen. My first experience in California. I had just left working for a company I'd been with for 3 years, and I was doing promotions around the U.S. And on the way from one promotion, I said, I'm going to go to California. Of course, I was trusting, and someone stole my backpack, and it had $1,000 cash. So I had to go to the youth hostel and stay where it was really cheap until I could recover my money. And that night, well, when I went for a job interview while I was out there to recover my money, the lady felt so sorry for me that she said, well, I have this friend, Russell, who's a singer, and he's up and coming, and he goes to a place called Dimples, and tonight he's the singer that they're going to use, and he'll cheer you up if you go out with him. So that night, I was with this guy, and he was singing to me, serenading me at this place called Dimples. So then, this other guy, I don't know, he sends me a corsage. And he starts singing to me. So Russell was singing this song out of Annette Beach Blanket Bingo, Annette Funicello song, Dream Lover. He's singing Dream Lover to me. Then this other guy, I don't even know, they're trying to cheer me up because I lost my money. He's another singer. He sends me a corsage. And then he starts singing some Mexican song to me, some love song. And then this director comes in named Jerry Weiss, and the owner of Dimples was good friends with this guy. So he sits in beside me at the table. And he was entertained because I was very scared of directors. And I'd heard terrible rumors. I've heard they drug you, they seduce you, and all this stuff. So I remember that night, he looked over and he goes, why are all these men serenading you? And I said, I don't know. I just met this guy today. And then he's intrigued because he can't understand what's going on. And then he sees I've got this cheap polyester suit on. I got it at a secondhand store. It's like lavender. And I'm so out of place. I'm dressed all prim and proper, nothing Hollywood. And I'm completely modest. And, you know, I was a good girl at the time. And he keeps trying to get me to go back to his place and get in his limousine and have Oriental food and go back in a hot tub. I said, nope, I'm going back to the YMCA. And he goes, what? you would like to go back and sleep at the YMCA when you can go sleep at my house? I said, yep. So then he wanted to dance with me. Well, I had Arthur Murray dance lessons, so he was very impressed. He thought I was a good dancer. So then he wants me to go dancing. I didn't go dancing, but he said, give me a call, and here's my number. I think you're really different. I want to keep in touch with you. And so later, when I was in California again, he took me dancing. He came and picked me up in this bomber jacket, and he took me dancing, and he liked it because I never would kiss him, never went to first base with him. And so even after I was married, he wanted to see me. And then when he got an Emmy, he sent a picture, love you, Sherry, baby, of him holding it up. And then he sent me Christmas cards every year because he knew I would celebrate Christmas. But he was Jewish, and he was friends with Jodie Foster. They were doing something with the art gallery together, and he knew everyone in Hollywood. But he thought that, you know, I had potential. And I said, I'm not interested. I'm a Christian. And at that time, I really wasn't. But I was interested in people that did have talent, you know? So I did help them until I went to a conference. And my life has been hell because I never knew that there could be Satan worshipers in the entertainment industry. Never. I used to go out with this one guy named Bob. And he was the role manager of the Four Seasons. And he even proposed to me one time. We made him come meet his kids at a ski lodge. And I didn't want to get married. I really didn't. The guy was a wonderful guy, and he asked me to go on a private island with Tom Jones, that Prince had rented a private island. I said, no, I wouldn't feel comfortable in that atmosphere, especially a whole week on a private plane with Tom Jones and a bunch of celebrities. I don't know. But when I was in Vegas, I got to go to all the Four Seasons shows for free. I got to hang out with the Four Tops. I went to Four Tops manager's house. I rode on their bus. I mean, I can meet anyone my whole life I ever want to meet. I've met Baryshnikov. If I wanted something, I had some power, I'd get it. I would get it. And it's just God's way of doing this for me. So this evil group got a hold of me and said I was a lucky charm. And they enslaved me for years. They had hit after hit, and I built them up. And then I said, I'm not going to do this because my spirit is connected to God. And what these people have done is prevented me from having any blessings in life for myself, anything personal or good at all. That's the devil. So lately, I'm getting my strength back. I will never recover, but as far as my connection to God. And I can only get blessings if it's what God wants. So I got out of my house again. I've done more this summer than I've done in 20 years. And I went to the fair with my husband, and there was this group singing. And I heard this one guy sing, and I liked him. And I says, Bob, I'd like to write songs for that guy. And I was sitting, I look over to the side of me, and I'm on the row. There's no seat. There's an opening here because I'm in the last seat. And then there's an aisle. And there's this guy standing beside me. And he's there for a while. I look over, and all these people keep coming around him and asking if their picture taken. And then I look over and I said, that's that guy who I said I would like to write songs for. And then I said to him, you know, you have the best voice. And then he thanked me. And I told him I was a songwriter. And instantly he said, can you wait so I can go to the dressing room and get you a business card? Because he wants to do business. And I'm like, I didn't even ask him if I could write songs for him. I'm like, this is magic. This is clicking. So I come home, I look the guy up on the computer. He grew up where I grew up, the West End. And I saw that they had been on a talent show, and one of them cried and said, you don't know how hard we worked to make our dreams come true. And I was just thinking when I listened to him sing, it's like with the Four Seasons, Gaudio helped make them who they are. And then as I heard his voice, I thought, he needs a song that helps give this group a powerful image, that lets people know who they are. And also sends a good message. And I'm rearranging a song tonight. But I think that the idea is perfect for this group. And I think the chorus is going to be perfect too. And it's something like, I wasn't born with a silver spoon, living on Star Paved Avenue, but I learned how to fight in life to make my dreams come true. You got to roll with the punches if you want to be a star. and climb the ladder of success if you want to go far. And then there was other parts of this I added, that not every road is straight in life, and you have to follow your intuition if you want to get through. And I'm adding a lot to this song, but if you look at the background of these men and see where they came from and how hard they had to struggle from poverty to get where they're going today, then I think this song is perfect to help launch their career. But it's great to have some local people that I can work with that are on the same page. And they said that they will not sell their soul for any kind of record deal. He did say that to me. And that he says he's working with a good company now that doesn't require anything like that to be successful. And it's just, the only reason this happened tonight is because I pushed that evil group out of my life. But in all the years they've been here, I'm dying. My health is failing. I can't create, because is God going to bless me surrounded by wolves and vampires and all these killers? No. I had the blessings before they came that I didn't realize I had. And God would have given me anything I wanted, anything I asked. But I never wanted fame. But I wanted the world. I just wanted to find my place. I wanted to make the world a better place. And I thought people in high places could set a good example to make the world a better place.